was a combination of hard work, dedication, and all-round amazing good team play that required every member of our team to pitch in and play certain roles on the team. I believe, Coach, you wanted to say a couple things about the team.
Yeah, I just wanted to say thank you for the support to all of you guys, but also to Dr. Cashman. We came to our state tournament, two of our three games, which was awesome. Just a little background on this girls' team. We only play six kids in the water at a time, and from last year to this year, we lost five of our starters. So for for all of these girls to step up and fill in those roles, we went from fifth in our conference this year to qualifying for the state tournament play-in tournament. We were the fifth seed in that tournament alone, and we upset the number four seed and the number one seed just to even qualify. These girls continually grew through the entire season, and like Dr. Bolton said, it was a true team effort, so congratulations. So we're telling you their best times, this challenges you this weekend, right? 15:51, and that's in the 5K, right? 15:59, Coach? Oh, no, all right.
You got to talk to the other coach.
There you go. Congratulations. congratulate and ask to come forward electrician Mr. Zach Stike and HVAC R technician Mr. Roger Aspen.
Thank you. Thank you.
I want to also give a shout out to the marching band. Congratulations to the Penn Ridge Marching Band on achieving their highest score of the season. They ended their season with an 88.2 and taking fourth place in the Cavalcade of Bands Patriot A Championship in Hershey. They were within tenths of a point of second and third place. The percussion section took first place with the Best Percussion Section Award, and a special thank you to the 2014 Penn Ridge graduate Jacob Wilmore, who came back to Penn Ridge to be their drumline instructor and led the drummers to the highest level. Please don't forget to check out their last performance of the fall as they kick off the Thanksgiving Day game against Quakertown. The pre-game show will start at about 10 a.m., so we hope to see you there. An announcement and just a reminder that Penn Ridge is now on Instagram. It's an additional way to connect with our students, families, and staff. Both the Penn Ridge School District and the Penn Ridge High School now have Instagram accounts. These accounts are another addition to the many ways we look to provide communication to our members of the Penn Ridge family. So please take a moment to follow us and keep up with all of the Penn Ridge proud moments. A big thank you to Ms. Cooper, who has been the spearhead behind this, and she's very proud of the fact that just in a short period of time, we have 800 followers. Very excited. Beyonce, look at So in September, those of you who were here know that the district announced goals for the year. One of those goals over the next 2 years is to study the research on sleep and discuss its impact on the Penn Ridge community. I've asked Dr. Tony Kuparczyk, who is our assistant superintendent for elementary education and has gone through this process in another school district, to coordinate this initiative for the district. Dr. Kuparczyk is not able to be here tonight for a family emergency, so I asked that he asked if I would step in for him. The first step of the process was an email and survey link that was sent out Friday to all staff members and families in the district to have two main purposes: to receive initial feedback from the community and gauge interest in individuals looking to serve on the district committee. Did it change, Mr. Nice. So the purpose of the study will to make sure that we understand the science and research related to adolescent sleep, educate all of our stakeholders. There will be sessions for students, for staff, and for community members of how sleep deprivation impacts adolescents, and determine the impact that change to school start times could have for Penn Ridge School District. There will be a committee that is formed in December from the survey results. One of the questions on the survey is, would you like to form on the committee? This committee will meet monthly beginning in December through the end of the school year to the beginning of next school year to look at various research as well as topics relating to the logistics of the possibility of a later school time. So you can see up here some of the things that are up there. The survey went out Friday. We have more than 400 responses. It'll be open until December 6th. I think that's the first Friday in December. It's open until the first Friday in December, so two more weeks. So please, if you have not interacted with that survey yet, please do so. We'll send the link out again weekly just to remind people if they got buried in your email from that standpoint. We will give updates at school board meetings, as well as there will be a dedicated website for all minutes and information that is studied by the committee, as well as the notes from their meetings, so that everyone can follow along at home if you have any questions, and that will be on our website soon. And as I also said, there will be speakers that we bring into the community with the goal to develop a recommendation and present it to the school year, to the school board. Just a sense for the timeline, this isn't the easiest thing in the world to read when it's on one slide, but to get a sense for when the timeline will happen, you'll see beginning in December, there's a section that says committee work. And so there's a lot of information in terms of what will happen from a community standpoint, but what role will the committee have as we move forward? And so you can see the committee work will begin in December, will lead through the June, and then really we'll move into the fall with an initial recommendation presented to the school board and the community. We'll then spend the fall and the winter talking about those recommendations and whether they make attendance to Penridge with a final recommendation due in February of 2021. Just a reminder, this is a two-year goal, a two-year study for conversation. The most important thing that you need to hear tonight that you make sure you take with you is this is not something where there's a right answer. We're just waiting 2 years to flip over the sheet and go, here we go, here's what we're doing, right? This is a committee that's going to come together. And the reason we're doing it through the survey is the committee is going to represent all stakeholders. Right? We want stakeholders that represent business, that represent all levels of education, that represent parents. We want people who are agreeable with this idea, people who are skeptical of this idea, so we can have all of those people in the room take a look at what this means, right? Look at the science and whether that does or does not impact the Penridge school. This will be a long process. All of that information will be public and will be on our website. And like I said, we'll have regular updates at both curriculum committee meetings as well as school committees. So we look forward to Dr. Barczyk and the committee's work. So thank you. All right, next we have the student leadership award.
The student council for the high school has two big events coming up. So all of our October events, that is our most busy time, is already over. And now we're moving on to November. So we have a two-week canned food drive going on at the high school. And we've gotten a lot of donations already. And we're on our second week now. So this Friday, we'll collect it all up. And then we'll figure out how we did against Quakertown. So it's a good ride, I believe. But and then next Tuesday, we have our fall breakfast in the cafeteria. So community's invited, students are also invited. It's in the cafeteria at 6:15, and we always have a good turnout, so we're excited. Thank you.
I apologize, but I also missed one announcement during the superintendent's report. I do want to recognize the donation. There was a $750 donation to be used for the music program at Dyler Elementary School from Miss Jennifer Gennetti. So we want to thank Miss Gennetti for her donation and the funds that will be used for the music program at Dyler. So thank you.
The breakfast is Tuesday.
Yes.
Not tomorrow.
No.
Not tomorrow. Not tomorrow. Next.
Okay, we're going to move on to the consent calendar. I'll make a motion to approve the consent calendar items A through I. Seconded by Mr. Rice. Questions or comments from board members? All those in favor? Aye. Opposed? Motion carries 6-0. And next we have the committee reports. Curriculum, Mrs. Cullen.
Thank you. The curriculum committee met on Veterans Day. The first one is a motion to approve the curriculum improvement proposals, the AP chemistry textbook, the Excel and Access certification program, and the high school music department honor ensemble. All of these things are some presentations for our
board. Seconded by Mr. Krause. Questions or comments from board members? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? Motion carries 6-0.
Thank you. Okay, the next one is the acceptance of mini grants from the Penridge Community Education Foundation with my lovely assistant. So this year we have six grants going to six different schools, a total of nine grants, $6,664.44. Represented by the big check. And for those who aren't familiar, who haven't heard this spiel about the PCEF, this is a foundation for the community that puts money right back into the classroom. So if you have an opportunity to make a donation, you can make a donation since the holidays are coming up, Gar Crawley at Bedminster for Duke Little Lego.
Oh, you have?
Yes, so if I, when I read your name, please come on down if you're here. So Tiffany Bates, Siler, Gar Crawley at Bedminster. Susie Showalter and Kate Shelley at West Rockville for Making IEP Goals Fun with Robotics. Margaret Bola from Bedminster with Magform Magnets. Okay. Kristen Otto at Sellersville for Flexible Seating. Lori Peterson and Megan McGovern at Bedminster for Enhancements for Bedminster Full Steam Ahead Club. Steam is science, technology, engineering, arts, and math. Brings together arts and STEM. Stephanie Schultz at Central for the All School Community Service Day. And I did want to just say that Service Day was awesome. It was a huge undertaking, so thank you. And Justin Berry at the high school for Real Interactive Periodic Table. And also Meg Ryan at the high school for the Penridge Nursery School. We just thank the PCEF again for bringing that money right into the classrooms for our students.
Just our thanks and our appreciation for all of the hard work and the amazing things. Thank you so much.